The main function of the plasma membrane of a cell is to keep the cells outside out and the cells insides in. But sometimes we need stuff to cross that membrane. Now, proteins embedded in the membrane, like a lot of transmembrane proteins, can act as conduits or channels. You've probably already learned about things like ion channels and ion pumps, so we can use both facilitated diffusion or active transport to move small molecules from one side of the membrane to another, but this isn't sufficient for moving large things or doing bulk transport. So if we want to move a lot of stuff at once, or if we want to move something large and or solid, then we're going to use vesicles. And vesicles are nothing more than little bubbles of membrane. So in this image we can see the three main forms of bringing stuff into the cell, which we refer to as endocytosis. So on the far left, if we want to bring something bulky and solid into the cell, essentially if we want to eat something that's outside of the cell, we're going to do phagocytosis, which means cell eating. So in this example, we have this red bacterial cell here, and we can see that the cell membrane is forming a pouch around the bacterium. Eventually, the two sides of the pouch will meet in the middle, and the bacterium will be brought into the intracellular environment surrounded by some plasma membrane. Sometimes we don't want to eat, we want to drink. And cell drinking is pinocytosis. And we call it this because we're essentially taking a little drip of the extracellular fluid and whatever is dissolved into it and bringing it into the cell. If we want to move something that is present in high quantity dissolved in the extracellular fluid into the cell, we're going to do pinocytosis. So for example, imagine that these little blue squares / diamonds, whatever, I don't know, they're arranged weird. Let's call them squares. These little blue squares, let's say that that's sugar. Sugar is usually very readily abundant in the extracellular fluid. So if a cell needs some sugar and it doesn't have a specific transporter protein for that sugar for whatever reason, it can do pinocytosis and be relatively assured that this rather energetically expensive process will be rewarded with ample of whatever the thing is in the extracellular fluid it wants. Sometimes, however, we want something that's more rare. So let's imagine that these orange stars are some rare molecule, something that would be in the extracellular fluid, but not in the kind of abundance that if we just randomly drank a drop of extracellular fluid, we would be likely to get it. So in this case, we need to enrich our endocytic vesicle with the thing we're trying to bring in. And in this case, we're going to use what's known as receptor-mediated endocytosis. So the cell, this little invagination, this little pit on the surface of the cell, is coated on the extracellular surface with receptors specific for a particular molecule, in this case, the orange star molecule. That pit is also coated on the intracellular surface with a protein called clathrin. And if we look more closely at this process in actual real tissue, we can see our clathrin-coated pits here. The clathrin is indicated by the arrowheads. You can see right in here the individual clathrin proteins lining this pit. Once the receptors on the extracellular surface of the pit are full, clathrin will initiate vesicle formation via endocytosis. So the clathrin will cause the pit to dip in like this. The ends of the pit will fuse together, and you end up with this now clathrin-coated endocytic vesicle. So this is a really good way for the cell to not waste the energy it takes to do endocytosis by ensuring that that vesicle is going to be full of whatever it is we're trying to get. So three different ways to bring stuff into the cell. We can do phagocytosis for solids, pinocytosis for abundant dissolved things, and then receptor-mediated endocytosis for less abundant dissolved things. If we want to get stuff out of the cell, we have to do the opposite of endocytosis, and that is exocytosis. And exocytosis is essentially endocytosis in reverse. So you have a vesicle that's filled with whatever it is the cell is trying to get rid of, and we don't distinguish with solids and liquids in this case because the cell can enrich this vesicle however it wants, but the vesicle in this case is full of neurotransmitter, and this presynaptic neuron here, so this is a a type of cell-cell junction called a synapse, which we'll get into more later. But this vesicle here, full of neurotransmitter, is going to be transported to the plasma membrane, where it will fuse with the membrane, and when it does, it releases its contents into the extracellular space, where in this case, it can go to the next cell down the line and initiate some sort of response from that downstream cell. So three ways to get stuff into the cell. We have phagocytosis, pinocytosis, and receptor-mediated endocytosis, and then any sort of removing stuff from the cell via a vesicle is called exocytosis. Well, that's it for now. Study hard. See you later.